China is not America's factory. China is the world's factory.
When it started moving, I thought it was a real cat. It's blowing my mind. It's crazy.
Hi, guys. Welcome back. We're on tour with Dridgers. If you're new here, we're a full-time travel couple from the UK. We are currently at the Canton Fair, and today we've got something really, really exciting. Do you know them robots that are taking over the world? Well, we are about to explore the unseen robots right now, which, I mean, it's going to blow your mind because I can't wait. I'm not actually alone. I've got a Chinese friend that's going to help me with a bit of translation because it's going to be a massive issue in these events. So come on in, Zach.
Hey guys, this is Zach. My channel is Zach in China. Well, I'm a reporter who does all sorts of videos and interesting explainers on China. And today I'm very excited to join the judges on our tour at the Canton Fair.
I am also here, but I am the camera woman today because free can be a crowd. But this place, this is the first time it's ever been here at the Canton Fair.
Well, this is obviously a very, very popular, it brings all the crowds. So I don't know how close we're going to get, but it looks like it's some sort of robot dog sort of thing.
This company is called Unitree. It's like one of the fastest growing and biggest robot company in China.
Really?
Really. And for the New Year's Gala, which is the biggest show every Chinese New Year, about 10 or 20 of these robots went to the stage and danced. It was viral.
Yeah. So that robot, what would that be used for? Like just service and stuff?
Well, for the moment, they will be used for like in the factories where they do inspections.
Oh, okay.
Well, yeah. Instead of human workers.
Yeah.
But you know, they're still working on other application scenarios.
So it's not actually doing anything. It's just sat down, like having a little bit of a break.
Yeah, and the dog's sleeping as well.
Oh. It looks actually quite small. It's not like the size of a person, is it?
No, it's literally like probably about 4'5" or something.
Right, let's see if we can find one that's moving about.
Can you just tell me about your product?
Well,
these are for inspection use.
Right.
Where they use in all sorts of factories, like chemical factories.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Where human would be dangerous. It would be dangerous for human to inspect the environment, and they use these robots.
So how much would like one of the so this unit here? How much would this cost?
这个多少钱啊?
这个是十万美金。十万美金。
对。$100,000.
$100,000.
Yes, it's not cheap.
No. 防水的,就风雨,风霜雨雪都能够运行。
It's waterproof and it can survive in all sorts of environments.
Right, okay. So this is covering a job which would have been done dangerously before? Or
yes, dangerously before by humans, but now humans don't have to risk their lives.
It's not worth the risk, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. We have the robots taking care of it.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you.
When it started moving, I thought it was a real cat.
but I prefer a real cat, actually.
Yes.
Yeah, I know, yeah.
It kind of creeps me
out. How much do these cost?
$189.
$189?
Yeah. Oh, 10.
Yeah. It's a little bit more expensive than a real cat, but but you haven't got to feed it.
That's true. So,
yeah.
Does it do anything else? Does it walk?
Does it walk?
Oh, no, it cannot walk.
Oh, this.
Yeah, you just hold it and wake it up.
It's a lazy cat.
It's a lazy cat. Sleeps all the time.
No, that's cool.
They asked the same question.
Did they?
Can't take it for a walk.
Can't take
it. Wow. That's well affordable. You'd never imagine it being like that cheap. Whoa. This place is unreal.
The future that everyone's going to have robot cats, a robot assistant, a robot everything. It's mad.
It's a rolling ball.
What's it used for?
Yeah, what is it?
Well, it's you can see back there from that photo, it's used by police forces. Where they can attack and defend.
So they would put like guns on the side or something?
No, there were no guns. This is non-lethal.
Non-lethal
machine, a robot.
It's like something you see out of a sci-fi film, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's got camera.
Yeah.
And when there's an enemy or there's a robot or something,
it just rolls and attack him. Yeah. Without like killing him or without severely hurting him.
So like knocking him down.
Yeah, just knock him down.
I do, like, when I see stuff like this, I do think, like, China are living so far in the future.
Exactly.
It's just like, yeah, it's literally like something you see in, like, the year 3000 on a sci-fi film. Right, let's carry on going. Lots to see.
This is what I wanted to see, these. Look at this.
It's taking a rest, I guess. That's
it sounds like it.
Whoa, it sits.
Oh, wow.
That one did it as well.
This one did it as well, yeah. Here's the honest.
They're currently sold out.
Really?
Already. Just 3 days. So Canton Fair. They already sold out.
Do they use them just for pets?
Mainly, they sell these products to. They have two kinds of products. One is for customers only. For customers only, you can use it as a pet or as a toy.
As a toy.
Yeah. And the other one is for factories, where they can design their own purposes, like patrolling or detecting problems.
Yeah.
So
can it report, like, if there is a problem, can it report back to maybe someone's mobile phone?
Yes, it can.
Oh, wow, that's amazing.
Oh, it's going.
Has it got a camera?
Yes, it's got a camera there.
Wow. So it's got a camera. So if it sees a problem, it can get on camera and send it to someone's phone.
Exactly.
Wow.
That's special. Special.
It's crazy, isn't it?
Yeah.
So is it controlling it by the phone?
I've no idea.
And how much was it? $350?
$3,500.
$3,500.
That's actually not
expensive if you get it for a toy.
Yeah, expensive it's a
expensive toy.
But not expensive for a factory, I guess.
No. It's cheaper than an employee, I suppose.
Yes. Come here. That's a backflip. No, real dogs can't do that.
Whoa. That is awesome.
Everyone's like, the crowd comes over straight away.
So he's put on the gloves and controls the hand.
I wonder how far away you have to be to have that work. I wonder if you could do that from a different room. That is mad though. Look how accurate it is. He's just moving his fingers so slightly.
So precise, the movements.
I guess they can use it as like surgical operations or something.
Yeah, they could do, yeah. When things are dangerous.
Yeah, things are dangerous.
So a dangerous job, they could have the robot hands do it. And he could be, you know, 10, 20 meters away.
Well, one thing about like the companies developing these robots is that I talked to one of them, who's like one of the biggest robot manufacturers here in Guangdong.
Yeah.
And the reason behind his company producing all these robots is because he met a worker who lost 4 of his fingers in the factory.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then from then on, he decided to make these robots to replace the workers to do dangerous work inside those factories.
That's what, like, we get some comments and they're like, oh, it's going to replace jobs and stuff, but when you're putting people's lives at risk, there's other jobs to do, there's safe jobs to do.
Yes, there are always safer jobs.
There's always safer jobs to do.
Yeah, and for dangerous jobs, we just leave it to the robots,
okay?
Leave
it to the robots, yeah. What is this used for? What's the purpose?
Agriculture. Spraying chemicals, spreading fertilizer, or transportation.
Really?
Yeah.
So how much would this cost?
UK, I think it's about $30,000.
$30,000. Yeah, that's quite reasonable, to be honest.
Can you lift me? Can you lift me up?
Yeah,
well. It's not for you, it's for delivery.
Do you weigh less than 70 kilos?
Oh, no, I weigh 75 kilos. Too bad.
I'm a lot more than that.
Yeah, the thing is, it's quite a short time though, 30 minutes. So we had to fly, do its job, and then come back, recharge.
Yeah.
It's work. Look at the size of it though. I didn't know you could get drones that big. Wow.
Well, they're now inventing drones that can transport people.
Really?
Drone taxis.
Oh yeah, drone taxis exist. Yeah, really. In Shenzhen.
Oh my god, that is scary.
It's big, isn't it? It's like a robot cow.
Imagine walking down a dark alley and that starts coming towards you. You'd literally poo your pants.
Nothing you can do.
I'm just taking my dog for a walk.
So like people talk about like China's known for the woe factory for its cheap labor. Well, what we see today is showing exactly it's not the case. It's not because China has cheap labor, but because China has all its robots improving the efficiency of the factories.
That's exactly what, like, when we've done the factory visit, that's exactly what we thought. It wasn't nothing to do with cheap labor because there was no labor.
Yeah, there was no labor.
It was all robots.
It's all robots there.
That's why they can make an electric car for $18,000 rather than $70,000.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's a no-brainer.
Replacing the cheap labor with these robots you don't have.
Yeah, so they take boxes around the factories.
Yes, exactly.
So this is brand new this year. Because you've been here before.
Yes, I've been here before.
Yeah. How many times?
For Canton Fair?
Yeah.
The fourth time.
Fourth time. So was this here last year? This year, this session. This is the first.
Yeah, we've never seen a sector completely for robots before.
Yeah. Is that why it's so popular?
Yeah.
Exactly. So,
yeah.
Everyone is here.
Yeah. I think some people are just here to see this, not even, like us, we're here to buy anything, we're just here to see it.
Right? Yes, exactly. It's interesting, they see many of those are American companies.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But now if they want to buy this stuff and bring it to America, they're going to have to pay 245% more tariffs.
it's their fault, isn't it? At the end of the day, right, China is not America's factory, China is the world's factory. So regardless if America want to pay more for it, let them pay for more for it, but the rest of the world is still going to buy it, so it's up to them.
Hello, sir. You sell this to hospitals, right?
Yes, I speak. You
can just tell us, yeah.
Okay. I just ask you questions. Because I am responsible for translating.
Oh, you're a translator. You know what the company is.
Okay, you're a translator.
Yeah, I worked here for only like 5 days.
Okay.
So this is basically used in like a rural setting where the hospitals are a little bit understaffed.
Yes.
Where they don't have a lot of doctors.
Yeah. So we basically need, in my country, in the NHS, are totally overwhelmed. If they had one or two of these in the hospital, then it'd obviously save a lot of people and get a lot of get diagnosed with different things and stuff. So, yeah, amazing.
How much would one of these cost?
$80,000, which is like $12,000 US.
Yes,
$12,000 US. It should be like that.
Is this for WeChat?
It's for the code number of its patient.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you can use your ID card.
Yeah, and then it straight away comes up. Yeah.
Wow.
Incredible.
In China as well, because in China there are a lot of rural areas.
Yes.
Yeah, now we have more hospitals, but still there are a very suburb area. We don't have enough hospitals, and this could be very helpful.
Yeah, for sure.
Definitely.
Yeah, amazing.
Thank you.
Right, we are at the medical bit, and we've just come across this. It looks like it does surgical procedures and stuff, like really precise. But I'm going to try and ask this woman about it, get a bit more information. It's obviously very popular. It's really interesting.
You can translate.
It's for bone surgeries.
Bone surgeries.
Only for your elbow and for your knee, something like that.
Hip as well.
It's like repairing the bone joint.
What your mum had done.
Yeah, exactly that. Yeah.
Well, when the doctor has to stand by the bed and holding that little grip over there, that's where the doctor will be holding it.
Yeah, so my mum had surgery in Lithuania very recently, and it would have been the same sort of things that they do here. Also, my best friend had
his cruciate ligament snapped, and that would have been surgery like this. So that obviously does all that sort of surgery.
Very, very clever.
But with this, it's more precise.
And, more precise.
Yeah, and it's, humans make mistakes, but robots don't.
Tell me about it. Tell me
about it. And how much?
Yeah.
$1.5 million.
Wow.
Dollars.
Wow.
Yeah, I suppose so. Like, for what it does.
Yes.
Can't put a price on it. It can literally... do a whole like country, couldn't it, or a region, or
thank you. Cheers.
That was amazing. Honestly, this place is blowing my mind. It's crazy. Big thank you to Zach for joining me, helping me translate, because there's a lot of things that we saw that I just wouldn't even know what to do. So anyway, we've got loads more to come from the Canton Fair, so remember to subscribe.